Hey everyone, the new RTX 50 series of GPUs is finally here and I'm really excited about it, apart from the power requirements. That's because the 40 series was plagued with negative stories about the new 12-volt power adapter melting and taking people's RTX 4090s with it, and also the new 50 series of GPUs actually use more power. So the RTX 5070 needs 50 watts more than the RTX 4070, and the RTX 5090 actually needs a whopping 125 watts more than the RTX 4090, which is a bit scary considering even the 4090 was melting. So if you're looking at upgrading to the 50 series of GPUs, do you actually need a new PSU? Well, I'll answer that in detail in this video so you have all the information you actually need to know. So I actually have two power supply units here. I got a white ATX 2.0, which is the Corsair RM750, so that's the white one, which is 2.0. And then I've got this black one, which is Corsair RM750, that is actually ATX 3.0. And what that meant is Corsair shipped the 12 volt power adapter in the box, so I could actually use this for powering any of NVIDIA's 40 series or 50 series of graphics cards, assuming of course the TDP doesn't get exceeded, because this is actually a 750 watt power supply unit. So if the actual graphics card says it needs 1000 watts, like the RTX 5090, I obviously couldn't use this one. But what's kind of confusing is, let's say this was actually a 1000 watt power supply unit, I probably still wouldn't use it to power my RTX 5090, even though it actually comes with a 12 volt power cable from Corsair. I probably still wouldn't use this, and I'll explain why throughout this video, but it kind of comes down to the quote, a chain is only as strong as its weakest link. But that would be one way of actually powering your 50 series of graphics card, is you get a ATX 3.0 or 3.1 PSU, and I'll talk about ATX 3.1 in a minute. You get one of them, you plug in the relevant cables into your PSU, and then you use the 12 volt power adapter to connect into your GPU, and that is a valid way of powering it, and that's the first way, and I'll talk about the pros and cons of that later. And it's mainly got advantages, not disadvantages, but I'll still talk about some of the flaws of this approach later on. The other way you could do it is you could carry on using your ATX 2.0 power supply unit, but of course you can actually sometimes go out and buy a cable directly from the PSU maker. So this is a type 4 connector type, and as a result I can go onto the Corsair store, I can buy a type 4 cable, and that'll actually give me a 12 volt power adapter. So then, because this is a 750 watt power supply unit, I could use that to power a few of the different 50 series of graphics cards. So that is something I could do, and that's the second way of actually doing things. The third thing you could actually do is you could keep your ATX 2.0 power supply unit, and then you can use the adapter that comes in the NVIDIA box. So for example, with the RTX 5070, it comes with an adapter that allows you to plug in two old style 8-pin PCI Express cables, and then that gives you a 12 volt power connector that you then plug into your graphics card, and that is quite a good option. It's why NVIDIA include in the box, but I personally wouldn't use that either. And again, I'll talk through where I would and wouldn't use all of these methods in a minute, but I just wanted to walk through the five different methods you could use for powering your RTX 50 series of graphics card. The fourth option open to you, again, is you keep your existing power supply unit and you go to a fairly good reputable company like CableMod and you buy one of their adapters. Obviously not the right angle adapter that got recalled after catching on fire, but you buy one of their other 12 volt power adapters and you actually use that. So that's the fourth way you could use. The final method is that you might have seen some power supply units actually have a native 12 volt power or 12 volt 2x6 power slot directly on the PSU. You could go out and buy one of those PSUs and use that. And actually that's the solution I would favor, and I'll explain why in a minute, but basically with that, you have less points of failure. And again, that comes down to a chain is only as strong as its weakest link. So part of the fundamental problem of the RTX 50 series, in my opinion, is it just needs so much power, and obviously the 12 volt power adapter isn't really suited for that. There's loads of stories online about how it's not really suited. And actually that's why the 12 volt 2x6 connector came in ATX 3.1, because what that did was actually change the sensing pins and the conductors inside to actually make things slightly safer, and there's been less stories of melting and things like that since that's been brought out. And that is actually one of the first points I needed to talk about. So with the actual change to this connector, some people actually get confused and think that you need to run out and buy a new PSU or a new cable. That's not actually the case. So this is an ATX 3.0 power supply unit and it comes with the 12 volt power cable, but I can't actually change this to a 12 volt 2x6 cable. The change for 12 volt 2x6 is on the female connector side. So this is a male plug that plugs into a graphics card, and it's actually at that point the connector on the graphics card that is actually changed with ATX 3.1 for the 12 volt 2x6 power connector. So in other words, if you have a cable like this, you don't actually need to run out and change it for a 12 volt 2x6 cable. You just need to make sure that your graphics card does actually use 12 volt 2x6 and not 12 volt power connectors. And you might be thinking, obviously that's going to be happening, but actually NVIDIA with the 40 Super Series, their actual graphics cards use 12 volt 2x6 connectors, but some of the board partners actually use the older style 12 volt power connector, which was a bit concerning considering it was melting, so I don't really know why they done that. But if you are buying an RTX 50 series of graphics card, just make sure it does have a 12 volt 2x6 connector on the graphics card side and not an older style one. And at the time of filming, it's actually a bit too early to say whether the board partners are using 12 volt or 12 volt 2x6 connectors. I'm assuming they are using the newer, safer version, but I just wanted to flag that point up. Right. So with all that said, you don't need to change your PSU in that case, but when do you need to change your power supply? Well, it all comes back to a chain is only as strong as its weakest link, and I know I've said that quite a few times, but essentially if you imagine a chain with loads of links, I can't really show that very well, I feel like I'm doing Incy Wincy Spider now or something, but if you imagine a big chain with loads of links, the idea is if one of the links is loose, then the entire chain will break. And the same is true of powering your RTX 50 series of graphics card. If you take the RTX 5090, for example, the adapter that's included in the box requires 4 8-pin PCI Express connectors. So in other words, you go out and you'd get an old school PCI Express cable with 8 pins on it. Like this one, this is a Corsair one, so you need to put it together. You'd get 4 of these, and what you were meant to do is actually plug that into your RTX 5090, and then at the other side of that adapter, you have a 12 volt power cable that you plug into your RTX 5090. And that sounds great, doesn't it? You don't need to change your PSU or even buy any new cables. Well, there is a massive fundamental flaw with that, in my opinion. So firstly, if you have an 8-pin cable, what you might notice is you've got this particular pigtail, and I won't rant about that much more. I got another video where I called this devil spawn and talked about how awful it is, but with the RTX 5090, you can't use the pigtail. Yep, so you can't get just 2 cables to then double up on the pigtail to get your 4 connections into the RTX 5090. You're not allowed to do that. This might not deliver enough power. So what you gotta actually do from your power supply unit is have 4 different PCI Express cables plugged into your PSU, and then you have 4 of these going into the RTX 5090's adapter, and then you've got 1 cable from there going into the RTX 5090. But have you thought about the problem yet? Well, you might have, but if not, I'll just explain it to you. Basically, on the PSU side, you've got 4 different things connecting to your PSU, so that's 4 things that could go wrong. Then on the adapter side, you've got 4 more of these plugging into the adapter, so that brings us to 8 different things that could go wrong. Then you have the 12 volt power adapter that goes into your RTX 5090. That is a 9th thing that could go wrong. So you don't need to just think about whether your 12 volt power cable is plugged all the way in, you've got to think about all the other things too. Of course, if you had an RTX 5070, that only needs 2 actual 8-pin connectors into the adapter, and that's actually not too bad. You know, you've then got 2 bits going into the PSU, 2 going into the adapter, and then the 1 bit going into your graphics card. But even then, that's still 5 different things that could go wrong. And whilst there's been no stories of melting RTX 4070s, the RTX 5070 does have more power, 50 watts more. And obviously if it's overclocked, it would use even more. And I personally wouldn't want to, you know, use my ATX 2.0 power supply unit and then use the included adapter for that purpose. And actually the same is true of some of the other methods I've mentioned, like going to CableMod and getting one of their adapters and maybe plugging in an 8-pin cable into my power supply unit. I personally wouldn't want to do that, and that's no disrespect to CableMod or anything like that. Again, I'm just introducing too many points of failure in that particular power chain. So that is 2 of the 5 methods that I spoke about earlier and why I would or wouldn't use them. The 3rd one, of course, is using an official cable from Corsair or something like that. So, you know, with your ATX 2.0 power supply unit, you go out, you buy an official Type 4 cable, for example, from them. That gives you 12 volt power and you plug that in. And I would probably do that for something like the RTX 5060 or the RTX 5070 because it's low power enough, but I wouldn't personally do that for an RTX 5090. It needs so much power, 575 watts, that I personally wouldn't actually trust plugging 2 bits of these into my power supply unit and then 1 into the RTX 5090. And that brings me on to what I would do to power, you know, an RTX 5090 or something like that. I would actually go out and buy a power supply unit that has an actual 12 volt power connector or 12 volt 2x6 connector on the PSU itself. And actually MSI Mag and Be Quiet and a few others do that. And actually at the time of filming, Corsair just announced a new RME 2025 updated power supply unit that also has a 12V-2x6 slot on the actual PSU itself. And what that means is you have one cable that plugs into the PSU, and then just one cable that connects into your GPU, for example, the RTX 5090 in this case. And that would actually, in my opinion, be the best thing you could possibly do, because then your power chain is just consisting of two things. One thing going into the PSU, one thing going into the graphics card. And then it comes to actually plugging in. And the general rules is make sure you plug in the cable all the way and there's no gaps around the connector, and then leave it. Don't start wiggling the cable and regularly pulling it out to see if it's, you know, in properly or not, because you could then actually not plug it in all the way. And obviously that's not what you want. So plug in one bit in the PSU, one bit in the GPU, just ram it all the way in there. No jokes, please. And then just leave it. Okay, so that is what I would personally recommend. Before I wrap up though, there are two points I really needed to talk about. Firstly, if you're looking at an ATX 3.0 or 3.1 PSU, which should you actually buy? And the problem is, it's not really a simple decision, because the ATX 3.1 power supply units are slightly more efficient, but in my opinion, they're not necessarily safer than the RTX 3.0 ones when it comes to powering the actual graphics card. You know, you are going to get slightly marginal gains with a 3.1 one, but it's not sort of super substantial that means you need to go out and chuck your ATX 3.0 power supply unit or anything like that. That will work as long as it's, you know, with the rated power and everything else. And that brings me to the second point. So this is a 750 watt power supply unit. And obviously there are some cards in the series like the RTX 5070 Ti that say the 750 watts is required. But of course that is the minimum, and that's also the specs from NVIDIA itself. So it's saying that you need that at the minimum for that particular card. But when it comes to the board partners, they might actually overclock a 5070 Ti and increase the power usage even more. And it might be that they then say you need an 800 watt power supply unit as its minimum level and not a 750 watt. So in other words, unless you buy in a Founders Edition directly from NVIDIA, which might not be possible due to scalpers and annoying things like that, you should always check the board partner's own power requirements in TDP when deciding what actual power supply unit to buy. And that really covers everything you need to know. If you've got any questions or concerns though, please leave me a comment. And if you found this video useful, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.